Hi guys, my name is Mandeep and in today's video we are going to discuss about recursion. Recursion is very important concept to learn and it's very confusing also. So let's get started. First we will take an example and then using that example we will build the definition of recursion. But we will find out some of the facts about recursion and then we will build the definition. So let's get started. I'm taking an example, very simple example, for factorial of a number. So let us suppose that this is a method or algorithm I'm writing over here, which is taking the recursive approach. So if n is equal to 0, return 1, else if n is equal to 1, return 1 again, and else for rest of the cases return n into fact of n minus 1. So since I have taken the factorial for using recursive approach, so this method is going to call itself for the smaller inputs. Every time it will come for the next iteration and the size of input gets decreasing and it will call itself till it reaches one of its base cases. These two are the base cases. So base cases are those cases where recursion ends. So after when recursion ends at one of these, so it will not call further itself for the next inputs. Fine. So this is the recursion example of an algorithm. And if recursion is not implemented properly, it may lead to run out of memory space. Let us assume that this same example, and suppose we have how it will behave in memory. I'm trying to describe that part. So let us assume that this is our memory, and for example, I'm taking an hypothetical case. Total is of 50 MB memory. 50 MB of memory, and out of which let us say 30 MB of memory is already used by the current running processes, and this is 20 MB of memory is the only memory which is free, right? So let us assume that when this function is going to execute, size of n is going to be 4. So again, assume that we are going to find out the factorial of 4. So how it will behave in memory? A recursive method, when calls itself, it creates a new copy of itself again, so in the memory. So for example, when we will pass the input n as 4 for the first time, it will call itself. Suppose this is a 4 factorial, and when I am calling that this is the 4 factorial for the first time, and when it will come over here, so it will be like 4 into, it will create one more copy of here, so it will be like 4 into 3 factorial, because when n minus 1, this method is going to be called again. So one more copy of this function is called over here, and similarly when it will be called further down, it will be like this way, 3 into 2 factorial, then 2 into 1 factorial, and further it will reach out to the base case. So for the size of n is equal to 4, there are going to be 5 copies of this function itself, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, using this example. And if I assume that this one copy of method is going to be take for example 5 MB. When it's going to be executed, suppose that it is going to take 5 MB of memory space while execution. So when the it will go further down, so it will be like 5 MB, it will take again because it is one more copy of this method, then 5 MB over here, 5 MB over here, and 5 MB over here. Fine. So how it will go, then further on it will return, 1 will be written here, then it will be 2 into 1, 2 will be written here. So 3 into 2, 6 will be written here, and 6 into 4, 24 will be written here. So this way. So what I am talking about, suppose if one copy of this recursive function method takes 5 MB, so it is going to 5 MB, it is going to take 25 MB. And I am taking it as an hypothetical case to make you visualization how recursive calls works in memory. And suppose at that point of time only 20 MB of memory is present or available, and this method is going to take 25 MB of memory to complete its execution. So because only 20 MB of memory is only available, so 5 MB of memory is not available, which is required by this whole stack trace, so it is going to run out of memory. So this is how recursion is quite important when it is going to be implemented. Any recursive call if goes into an infinite loop, or any recursive call is executed with very limited memory space, which is less than the required by itself, it will give us the memory out of space exception. So this is a whole idea about how recursion works. So from this whole of the discussion, if we have to find out some key points over here. So key points over here are recursive function calls itself. One of key point over here is this. Second key point is that recursive call makes a copy of itself at each iteration. Recursion terminates at base case. So building on these facts, we can make the definition of recursion. So that's all about today's topic, which is recursion. So if you guys think that this is worthy learning, so you guys can like, subscribe, comment. Please do it. Please subscribe my channel. Thanks for watching.